Okay, so hello guys, in this video we are going to see how to print the factorial of any number. So if you are new to coding, then to print the factorial of any number is like really a basic thing in coding. So you need to understand the logic behind it instead of just learning or cramming the code, then there's no point in it. So you need to understand the logic. So for understanding the logic, first let's see this picture. So 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial is 2 into 1. So see what is here. This 2 into 1 factorial. So see, 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. So we can say 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1 is basically 2 factorial. So 3 factorial is 3 into 2 factorial. So similarly 4 factorial equals to 4 into 3 factorial. See, 3 factorial. So that's why you can say n factorial equals to n into n minus 1's factorial. So in this way a computer can think. You can say it like that. A computer can think like that. Because we can't just give any input every time and it will print the factorial. We need to understand the logic behind it. So suppose we are taking n as input, and remember n will be an integer, because factorials are defined only for integers, so we can take only integers. And remember, we don't want negative integers, so for discarding the negative integers case, we'll see it afterwards. First let's print the factorial for positive numbers, and it is not defined for fractions as well, that's why we specifically wrote here n. So after that, suppose let us start a variable named factorial. It will be easy. So factorial equals to 1. Now we have to print. So now we'll use a for loop. So suppose see, we write for any I in range. Now range we can start from 0. Sorry, range. Range we can start from 0 up to n. But see, we'll write range afterwards. See, I'll tell you why. So factorial, we want to write it like this. Factorial of n into factorial of n minus 1. So how do I write n minus 1's factorial? So for that I'll just write into I. So suppose see, factorial has started from 0. So I write, we want the factorial of suppose 3, let's say. So we'll have to start it from 1. Because see, if I start it from 0, then factorial will be factorial into 0. So everything will be 0, 0, 0. So for that I'll start it from 1 instead of 0. And it will go up to n. But see, in range function, whatever we write in this side of parenthesis, it gets excluded. That's why you'll just write n plus 1. So that n gets included and n plus 1 gets excluded. That's why. So suppose see, factorial we want factorial of 3. So now factorial is 1. So for I in range, 1, 2, 3 plus 1 is 4. So it basically range will be 1 to 4, that is 1 to 3, because 4 gets excluded. So first of all, I will become 1 because we started from 1. So 1 equals to, no, we can say factorial actually, because we are equating it to factorial, that's why. Factorial equals to, now factorial is 1, so factorial equals to 1 into 1. So we get up to 1. Now I becomes 2. So 2, so factorial equals to 1 now, because previous factorial was 1. 1 into 2, so it will become 2 now. Now factorial is 2, now 3. So for when I becomes 3, factorial equals to, this factorial is 2 now, because previous factorial was 2. So factorial equals to 2 into 3 now, that is 6. So we get factorial of 3 equals to 6. In this way it works. So I just need to print the value of factorial now. So I'll just print factorial, because everything is done up now. So now here comes the case when I said that we don't want any negative integers. So for doing that, I'll just write a if condition. So if n is less than 0, or we can just write if n is greater than 0 firstly, greater than or equal to 0 as well, because n can be 0, then we want this all code to execute. So I'll just indent it carefully. Okay, fine. Now comes the case when n is greater than 0, that is simply else. So if this happens, then I'll just give the directions to user that incorrect number entered or invalid input. Okay, invalid input. Okay, now let us try to check it. So suppose we want to print the factorial of 5. 5 factorial is 120. Okay, nice. And now suppose I enter in a negative number, like I enter minus 6. Invalid input. Okay, works fine. So in this way, the logic behind factorial works. So this code is really easy and basic. You need to understand the logic behind it to get it. Okay, thank you.